brains are made of cells, and like these nerve cells, and these bacteria, and cells have a lot of membranes. So here's the membrane with its phospholipids. And actually, can you push these? This is forward and reverse. Yeah, forward and reverse. And I'll get up here and point to this. This laser is giving out on me. Let's see, can you hand me that meter stick? I'll point to this. So our membrane phospholipids, transmembrane proteins acting like pumps and so forth. Okay, next.
Can I ask a question?
Protein machine, you can focus it. See the focus knob there? On the, did you find it?
It's on the right side or what?
Focus is on the front. All right, see, this is focus, right there. Yeah, right there, okay. So here's our protein machine. So here's a class one myosin motor, motoring along an actin filament. And next we have pumps like the chlorine pump, pumping chlorine through. And next we have enzymes like the enzyme lysozyme grabbing its substrate here in the active site and breaking it down in this case. Okay, powering the machines, we have the energy systems. They're in the mitochondria. Here's the mitochondria of liver cells of a human being. Next, we have the electron transport chain. There's that cartoon again showing the electrons, metaphor of a waterfall, like water falling over waterfall. The electrons travel from one protein to another, usually through iron and copper atoms. And as they fall in voltage, they release energy, which powers the cell. Next, here again is cytochrome C. If we go back a slide, here's cytochrome C right there. Okay, that's this protein. It has an iron atom in it, and it gives its electrons to cytochrome C oxidase right here, which has a copper atom in it. And now I'll show you these two. Here's cytochrome C with the iron atom. Electricity goes flashing through there. Next. Cytochrome C oxidase, which has copper atom cofactors. Electricity goes flashing through the middle of that protein like a transistor. Next, the falling electron, here's cytochrome C again. The falling electrons turn this turbine-like thing right here called ATP synthase, spins at about 120 revolutions per second, and it makes what? ATP, and then ATP is what actually powers the machines with its charge effects and things that we'll learn about in not too long. Here's the enzyme hexokinase. Here's a photosystem absorbing the light, kicking the electrons up. Here's glucose sugar. Okay, the next slides show a little more detail. So light from the sun hits
light from the sun.
Well, I was actually telling her to light from the sun hits the chloroplast of plant. Good for you guys. Hits the chloroplast of plant cells. Next slide shows the photosystems. Here's the chlorophyll molecules with magnesium atoms in the middle. Electrons from water in here get kicked up. They go zinging off as high voltage electrons. Next slide. They get stored on glucose sugar, which acts like a battery. High energy electrons are here in the carbon and the hydrogen atoms right in there where it's black and white. Next we have, so that's the energy harnessing system. Finally, DNA does what? Makes the protein machines. And every three nucleotides in DNA codes for the production of one protein machine. Let's look at my next slide, my cartoon again. Boy, ridiculously small, I know, but here's the DNA in red, again, makes RNA in orange, which makes protein. Here's a protein machine, it's a long chain of amino acids. You have to string the amino acids together in the right order. Here's the 20 amino acids with their variable R group sticking off. And the DNA is made of four bases called adenine, thymine, guanine, and cytosine, ATG and C. The double helix splits. You lay down a copy of the DNA called RNA with these A's, with A's, U's, G's, and C's. I don't know. Can you guys see these letters at all from where you are?
Yes.
A little bit? Okay. Yeah. We'll just kind of pretend. So, for example, to put in the amino acid tyrosine right there, you have a U, A, C. Okay, U, A, C. What does that put in? U, A, C puts in, sure enough, the amino acid tyrosine. And this codon, A, 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 puts in lysine. Say it. A,
A,
A. I can't even see it here. A, 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 A puts in lysine. And let's do one more. U, G, C puts in what? U, G, C right there puts in lysine. And you get the idea. So there's 64 codons. See, there's all 64 codons putting in 20 amino acids. And that's what DNA does. It's a code. It's a genetic code to string amino acids together to make these marvelous protein machines. Okay, the next slide. Let's go on to the next one. Okay, a little bit about bacteria. So with some luck, we're going to have time to study bacteria in the lab. And here again is this sharp point of a needle. Next slide. Keep going, blowing up the bacteria. One more. Okay, there's E. coli bacteria. Okay, what I'm thinking about right now is I'm calculating in my mind. The day class didn't meet Monday, and I don't want to get too far ahead of the day class, so I think we're going to get out early tonight. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to show you bacteria here, and then we'll leave, okay? So just enough about bacteria to appreciate their shapes and so forth. So bacteria are tiny cells. They're called prokaryotes. Let's review this formulation. Talk with me. There's two main kinds of cells in biology. There's little, tiny, simple cells, which are bacteria, and everything else in biology is made of big, huge, complicated cells that are at least 10 times as wide, at least 1,000 times as heavy, and that's, you know, animals, plants, mushrooms, amoebas, and so forth. Well, did I go through that formulation with this class yet?
No.
I don't think I did. Okay, that's really important. We better do it once more. Again, repeat. Two main kinds of cells in biology, little, tiny, simple cells, which are bacteria, and everything else is biology, animals, plants, mushrooms, which are fungi, amoebas, are all made of big, huge, complicated cells that are at least 10 times as wide as a bacteria, at least 1,000 times as heavy as a bacteria, and those are called eukaryote cells. The little tiny simple ones are called prokaryotes. This is all in your study packet and the book. Prokaryotes are the bacteria. What does that mean? Before nucleus, Latin or Greek, because they have no nucleus. And eukaryote cells, EU means good or true. And so it means true nucleus, because their DNA is wrapped in a nucleus, and they're much more complex. So we're talking now about the prokaryote. Was there a question? Yes.
Is a virus a eukaryote or prokaryote?
A virus is neither. Viruses are completely in a class by themselves. Viruses are not even considered to be living things by most biochemists. They're too simple. Viruses are dangerous biochemicals, basically, with RNA or DNA genomes, protein coats. They're parasites that go inside living cells and replicate themselves. They don't do most of the five things that living cells do that we talked about. Okay, now bacteria This is E. coli. This is a rod-shaped bacteria. Bacteria come in three main shapes. Let's do a kinesthetic. Rod-shaped are called bacilli. And I've got a good picture of this in the... Well, I've got a diagram that I'll talk you through later. Don't worry too much about this. Bacilli has two L's in it, and that reminds you of the two L's like this, remind you of a rod shape. And then you can have round bacteria, and those are called cocci. C-O-C-C-I. And the cocci has an O in it, round. And then finally you can have spiral shape, and those are called spirilli. Okay, so name them. Cocci, bacilli, spirilli. Some of them are V-shaped, and those are called vibrios, which begins with a V, vibrio. Okay, so next slide. Here is E. coli again from the human gut. It's a bacillus. Next. Here is another bacillus, tuberculosis, causing the deadly disease tuberculosis. And the next slide shows a different strain of tuberculosis. These are artificially colored, by the way, almost all these photographs. Most bacteria would look a dull, boring, kind of a brownish or gray color. But anyway, that's a drug-resistant strain of tuberculosis that has arisen. Next slide shows cocci. That's Staphylococcus aureus, staph A. You've all heard of staph infections, like skin infections. Staph A. And next, here is a neat picture, colorized, that shows just a few of the species of bacteria in the human gut. And you have something like 500 different species of bacteria in your gut that help us digest food. Very complex. In fact, this whole thing is considered now really to be a whole organ in and of itself, helping us digest food. The next slide. Okay, bacteria have a cytoplasm with ribosomes making proteins. Here's the DNA. No nucleus. They all have a membrane, shown in yellow. They all have a cell wall, shown in black, to make them tough and rigid. And then some bacteria, the gram-negative bacteria, have a second membrane on the outside. Say that. Some bacteria have a second outer membrane on the outside. Some don't have that second membrane. Those are the gram-positive bacteria. Next slide. Here's bacteria caught in the act of dividing by fission. There's the DNA. And next slide. These are called actinomycetes, and these are a class of bacteria that we get most of our antibiotics from. Bacteria fight with each other. They wage warfare with each other with antibiotics. One bacteria will try to kill a different bacteria with natural antibiotics. And most of our most famous antibiotics, like tetracycline, erythromycin, streptomycin, they come from these actinomycete bacteria. The next slide shows the smallest of all living cells. These are called mycoplasmas. They're prokaryote cells. These are only about a tenth the size of a typical bacteria, or about a tenth the size of a mitochondria. These live as parasites inside other cells. You can often get contamination from mycoplasmas when you're culturing cells. So smallest of all living cells. And then the next slide. There's a class of prokaryotes called archaebacteria. They're actually put in their own kingdom. These are extremophiles. What is that? File means love. These are lovers of extreme conditions. Like they can be found in growing in hotter than boiling.